Hi, welcome to this short video about last mile security between API management proxy servers and your backend servers. One of our most frequently asked questions is, how can I secure the connection between API management proxy servers and my backend so that a random person who happens to know the URL of my backend cannot hit my services directly? Currently, in Azure API Management, there are two solutions. First, you can use HTTP basic authentication, or you can use shared secret authentication. In this video, we will go through both of them. To enable HTTP basic authentication, first, you need to enable that in your web server that hosts your APIs. In this example, I will use IIS to show you how to enable that. Now I'm in the IIS manager. Double-click on Authentication. Right-click on Basic Authentication. Choose Enable. Now Basic Authentication has been enabled in my server. The next step is to create a user to be used by the proxy server. I'm in the computer management of my Windows server. Go to Local Users and Groups. Right-click on Users and create a new user. Okay, now I have created the user to be used by the proxy server. I'm going to configure that in API Management. I am now in the Management Console of Azure API Management. Navigate to the API section. Click on the APIs that I want to apply basic authentication. Go to the Settings tab. Pick Basic in the With Credentials drop-down. Type in the username and password I just created. Click Save, and you are all set. Cool, so now you've learned basic authentication. Next, we are going to show you how to do shared secret authentication. Basically, how this works is, first, as the API publisher, you will generate a shared secret. And then, you will configure that secret in the management console of the proxy server. After that, the proxy server will apply that secret in the HTTP header of each request sent from the proxy to your backend. And of course, your backend needs to add some custom logic to verify that secret. To configure the shared secret in HTTP headers, it is also very simple. You can use our policy feature. I'm in the management console again. Navigate to policies. Pick the proper scope that you want the policy to be applied. In this case, I will just choose one API. Click on Add Policy. Identify the inbound section. Then, from the list on your right, choose Set HTTP Header. And then enter the name and the value of the header field. So this is a key generated by the backend. Click Save, and you are all set. Finally, I want to mention that if you are going to use either options described in this video, please use them together with SSL. Otherwise, the password or the shared secret will be transferred in plain text over the internet, which is vulnerable to the man-in-the-middle attack. Thanks for watching. I hope this is useful. If you have any questions, please feel free to reach out to me or to the team. Thank you. Until next time.